Rory, we should talk about Gat Bill.
Yeah, let's talk about Gat Bill. I think we're about to show you a pretty good representation of what Gat Bill is.
I think a lot of the footage will definitely talk for itself.
Yeah.
Doing his hands.
We went to Gat Bill for the first time in 2013.
It was amazing.
Insane. I just fell in love with the place. And in 2017, I brought my car back for once off, but then we just brought it again.
Yeah, that was great. That's episode 3 of the vlogs, if you haven't seen it.
Turny.
Last year, you built your car for Gat Bill, and then you drove from Ireland, from here, the shed, all the way to Norway and back again.
Yes! But as you can see,
we went again.
Snapback area, look back.
What are you doing there?
A bit of sun here.
We made the boat and Barry on his own.
Instant Jeremy Kyle.
That's the present. Where are we going?
Go. Barry's always trying to get the camera.
The lads got a bad ex-government van that was limited to 100 kilometers an hour, no air conditioning, no comfort, literally like a 90 degree wooden shelf in the back.
And we're on that on the boat. We're off the boat.
Stick around to 7 high.
That's only the best fucking shot I've ever had in months. The lines in the water are fucking slide the head on you, so it isn't the same power. That's some fucking shower now. I'm after throwing the balls off myself.
They interconnect and relay it, look.
T-6061.
Don't bite that thing at me! Don't bite!
Get your fucking hand off that! It's aircraft grade. And you wouldn't go past something like this now if you're on the street.
Excited?
I love this!
Are you excited?
I love it!
You're an army man.
I'm in the army!
Oh, army man.
The size of this place is just the words can't put on beside herself.
We are in Rotterdam.
We're in Rotterdam.
We're going. Where are we going?
We're going to Gat Bill.
We're going nowhere. And we're in the Netherlands.
I'm stressing out. Awesome.
We just tried to drive a trailer with a race car on it and a van just into Amsterdam.
Yeah, we said basically our ferry overnight from the UK, we landed near Amsterdam and we said, sure, look, we're only half an hour from Amsterdam. We may as well go into the city centre.
Have a look.
With a van and a trailer. No, it doesn't work unless you're on a bicycle.
Yep, we didn't think about that. Poor Barry McGrath, he said he would stay with the van and trailer because we didn't want to leave the car in the middle of nowhere.
Barry has decided to just sit with the car.
Yeah.
That's painful.
Really?
Welcome, we're live here on the streets of Heineken. Streets of Amsterdam.
Heineken.
And welcome to the vlog.
Yeah, we're fogged. Much.
We enjoyed Amsterdam.
Yeah.
For like literally 2 or 3 hours.
Alright.
Oh Jesus!
Yeah, so our van is limited to 100 kilometers an hour and we're on the autobahn now, we're on it now actually!
I sat down on the trailer of where the car was on and we were about to hit the road, so we all jumped in the van. We're heading down the road. We're after traveling about 70 or 80 kilometers.
Yeah.
And I realized that I didn't have my phone.
I was driving, then I heard someone have a conversation about your phone being missing. And then you were looking for the phone and I said, do I need to turn around? And you were like, maybe. I said, do I need to turn around? And you said, yeah.
Yeah, I was over.
We're not leaving the fucking phone behind. We're going back for that phone. Even though we're in a rush.
So suddenly we were going 100 kilometers back the wrong direction.
Yeah, and we passed the other guys. There was other guys on a road trip from Ireland. And we'd passed them out. And then we passed against them going the wrong way.
And they were wondering
why
we were going the wrong way. And then we went back to the service station. And I went in looking around everywhere. I said, hey, have you seen my phone? Have you seen my phone?
Have you seen my phone?
Nobody had seen my phone.
So, it's gone. But we had to drive 100 kilometers to go find it. And then come back another 100 kilometers. And it's gone.
Come here! Look where it is!
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Is that where it was?
Yeah. Look at that.
Like a wheel.
Holy shit, we didn't put it there.
You think we put that there?
That was
we
there.
We let
you.
I found it and the little squeal inside, it was amazing.
Oh.
The phone was wedged between the mud guard and the trailer for pretty much 200 kilometers. It's incredible.
Yeah.
I was pretty much over the phone, but I was quite happy to have it because it's quite
a lot of memories.
Yes.
On the phone.
On the phone. Your hands are freezing.
Yeah, fucking yeah. Well, Barry done a legendary drive.
Yeah, he drove for almost
from Amsterdam to Gothenburg.
We're on another ferry.
Oh, we're on another ferry.
Love boat.
Loads of beer, loads of trucks.
Made for it.
We stopped near Gothenburg and we hit a wall of tiredness and a wall of fog.
Yeah, we shouldn't have drove for that long, but
Barry, you don't have to keep driving. We can stop now. It was like 4 a.m. and then we all just slept on the side of the road.
Yeah,
and
it was pretty rough.
Where are we?
We made it with the trucks. We got our 2 trucks here just on time.
Yeah, we finally. It took a long time to get the trucks up, but.
Yeah. But we're in Rudskogen.
Gorgeous. Before we go home.
The
Yeah, so we just got our space, which we were nicely allocated.
15 by 9 meters,
somewhere over here, somewhere down there, somewhere around here.
fucking good cans. Yeah, so upside down.
Yeah. Oh no! Oh my.
They got us a house and everything. It's blue. Funny, yeah. Well, I'm here, Barry. Josh.
Josh.
Just Josh, basically.
Just Josh.
So you think you would be trying to get a fresh start for this crazy event that we're going to, but we were already drinking and pretty fucked by the time we got there.
Yeah, because when you get to Gapel, it's like, okay, we're here now.
Yeah, it's 1,000 miles an hour.
We're not going to really sleep for...
for the whole event.
Literally a dream of mine,
yep,
to have my car at Gapel, to be in such a place that I just fucking love the place. So then to actually build a car or have a car there and bring it all the way from Ireland to just be there and be drifting and be like part of the mayhem was just absolutely mind blowing.
So I'm in a race suit. This is Josh's race suit. I have no voice because we were drinking. Me and Ruben are going to go out and do a skate. What the fuck is going on?
Like a 70s Formula One driver or something.
So pretty much you're with your mates, you're playing Forza or Gran Turismo, and you just load up like a racetrack, and it's an open lobby, and everybody just goes out and everybody has the most maxed out car. They've spent all their money in the game on the craziest car ever. It's like 1200 horsepower, and everyone's on the track and they're just having a fucking shit show. But Gapel is that in real life. It's just like money's no object, and you can pretty much expect everything on the track in every combination possible. Stand right, hang on. Stand in with the sun. I want the sun to light up the back of your head. Watch. Stay there.
This is my happy face in the happy place. This is me live on the runway.
Somehow we're out on the main bend.
Yeah.
Just gonna photo shoot at the car.
Yeah. This is my favorite bend, and my favorite place where all of my favorite people are here, and my favorite car that I built for this place. This is fucking great. There's a helicopter up there. A fucking helicopter.
Zoom in on the helicopter.
Room for everyone in the right back.
Look at that.
So packed.
It's spacious.
Look how spacious it is.
Because we've made good friends, like the guys from JSpec and Patrick and his mates, we got a really good setup where the lads have their whole tent and they let us camp in with them, man. It's a cool crew.
We have another hole in the radiator. We actually do. This radiator delivered to us from Sweden by JSpec. So, and they gave us loads of AN fittings and loads of shit, like, for nothing.
So, nicest guys in the world.
Yeah.
Our Swedish family.
Are you on? Water, weather, do you know that stuff? Don't laugh, boy. I'm having time in life.
I don't know.
What?
It's G-Star.
Wow.
Gets a proper windmill on.
This is ridiculous, man. Here, Ruben.
And where's that?
That's a feisty one. You can't catch it. You're gonna run.
Oh my god, the size of it!
Fucking hell.
I hope that's a fish eye.
Yeah, it is, yeah, it makes it even more ridiculous.
Yeah. Go on if you like.
There we go. Just when you think you don't have enough.
Well, it's in, it's finished.
Fuck it!
Number 21, mate. Number 21. Get that in there.
So much coffee.
Yeah.
Holy man, in practice.
Had the secret ingredient.
We're there for you. Hang on, a little bit of that. And especially.
Like, I don't know, Gapville is, it's just crazy. Gapville is like one big family, yeah. It's a feeling.
It's like the wildest imagination. Like, if you're into cars and money is kind of no object for a lot of these people, and their imagination literally runs wild, everything is just there. If you want to just put the craziest engine, there's a Koenigsegg engine in a Granada.
Yeah.
There's a Viper V12 engine in an S2000. We'll be right back.
there's actually fucking a car show on at the same time as all the madness, and we never really make it down here. There's a shitload to take in here. It's quite hard to actually see it all. Drove from the UK in their 86 and they just put a new axle in it. It's pretty ballsy. Check the engine bay, this TA60.
Definitely has the most unique, I'm gonna put it out there, the most unique lineup of cars
in the world.
Anywhere together in the world.
It's like going to a music festival. It's 3 days of just no sleep, drinking, craziness. The sun never sets, so it just fucks with our Irish heads.
Yeah, so why would you go to bed?
Yeah.
Why would you? You have to drive a drift car in the morning.
There's no nighttime.
Exactly why you should go to bed.
Yeah, so Ruben got some sleep.
So this moron stayed up way too late.
Good morning. What the fuck's going on?
Get out!
How you feeling there now?
Oh great, I'm 100%. It's game day, we're ready to smoke some tires now.
Smoke some cigarettes?
I'm gonna smoke bags.
Everyone there is just out for a good time. They're all there for the same reason. Everyone's there to have a good time, show off their cars, and just go fucking bananas.
Yeah.
Dance before bed. Go on, Ruben, shake it.
Ruben! Baby!
And it's very hard to put it into words what the place is like. You just gotta go there and then go. What a weekend.
The best part was then Ruben just left his car in Sweden.
What?
Or Norway. Ruben left his car at Gapwell.
Shit, yeah.
Yeah.
Fuck.
So for the whole last year, Ruben's car has lived in Sweden.
Shit, yeah.
So we drove home with an empty trailer. You had an opportunity to leave your car there and get up to some other antics and...
Yeah, so basically we were getting ready to hit the road.
The car was on the trailer, loaded, ready to go home.
Yeah,
we were ready to leave.
Go. We got to go catch the ferry. Basically the lads from J-Spec No Coast Racing, our Swedish friend, said, hey, do you want to just leave your car here and you can maybe fly over and do some more gap builds or do some ice drifting? And then... You all said, yeah, that's a great idea.
Yeah.
And I said, oh shit, okay. I took my car off the trailer, I ran over, I gave someone the key. He was like, what the fuck are you giving me the key? And I said, I'm leaving my car here. You got to take it to Sweden. We're going back to Ireland now. And then we made the boat with an empty trailer and I kind of went.
Yeah, you're pretty wiped out.
Like, it's a fucking year later and my car is still there. I'm just back from Gapville and yeah. I was supposed to bring it home a couple of weeks ago.
And this video is a year old because the videos are a year behind now. 1 year behind. But hey, look, lots of movies and TV shows are all made years in advance.
Yeah,
so
I mean, look at the Titanic. That took fucking years. I don't know.
Look, go to Gapville.
Was this video a good summary of Gapville?
Yeah.
Well then, if you liked it, then you should go. If you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.
I hope you enjoyed a video of a bunch of Irish guys with essentially a guy that just threw a car together.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
No, he doesn't, but he does. Loaded onto a trailer and then drove in a really terrible transit van all the way to Norway, farting on each other, and then driving home again, back to here, our little area of nonsense. And if you're into cars, it's probably one of the greatest things you could ever do.
Yeah.
The sun never sets and the fun never stops.
Ah, oh, man, we got it, we did it, yeah, bro.
See you next time.
See ya, that was fun. Whoa, that was crazy, man. You guys are fucking nuts.